lie for the dead homies. Fuck you and your dead homies. I put dead homies on your head, homie. Appeal money for the fair homies.
Hey, what's the deal? What's the deal? What's the deal? Your boy LB, back with another one of them things, mate. One time for the one time, you know what it is up over there. Check it out, though. Check it out. Today, on the last day of Michigan week, bro, we got Eminem, Venom. Now, a while ago, when he had this whole little shit with him and MGK, and by the way, if you ain't checked out my Kill Shot, or you ain't checked out my MGK, neither one of their reactions, definitely go check them two motherfuckers out for real. I highly recommend those, not just because it's me, but just because I think that's some of my best motherfucking work, my nigga. Guys. But anyway, though, bro. So around that time, I had did those, and I had did that other reaction. I forgot the name of the song, but it's like where M was running from the black shit, and the black shit cut him. So a subscriber that got at me about this one, wanted me to do this for Michigan Week, was like, this kind of ties into that video, and it ties into the Venom movie. So, Eminem, pure unadulterated motherfucking genius, nigga. So, like, oh, also, I don't think y'all answered my question up on the last one. Does Eminem support up-and-coming talent about a Michigan or Detroit? You feel what I'm saying? Does he let niggas go on Shea 45 for interviews? Do he do shows, promotions, or anything like that? Like, does he let their songs get played on his station? Like, let me know something, bro. So I take it that's supposed to be the Venom little shit too that he just so is okay. Let's put this timeline together, baby.
Oh, wait up.
I got a song filled with shit for the strong-willed. When the world gives you a raw deal, set you off till you scream, piss off, screw you when it talks to you like you don't belong. It tells you you're in the wrong field when something's in your mitochondria, cause it lats on to you like knock, knock, let the devil in, malevolent as I've ever been. Head is spinning, this medicine screaming, nick, 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 let us in. It nick, nick, like a solid ball, let your Allen pole. Bedridden, should have been dead a long time ago.
Marshall motherfucking Mathers. And he's one of the, before I get to what I'm saying, he's one of the smart motherfuckers in the game because he made a play off his government name. Like your motherfucking name is Marshall Mathers, M and M, but instead of doing M and M, you spelt the shit out. Like, it's fucking genius. I've always thought that was one genius thing about him, bro. But in regards to this song right here, is this on the Venom soundtrack, or is this just something that he did comparing himself? Cause y'all was like, that's him, like in that other video, y'all was telling me that that's Slim Shady catching up to Marshall Mathers, and Slim Shady taking back over. You feel what I'm saying? Because if you an Eminem fan, Marshall Mathers, Slim Shady, whatever you want to call it, you well aware they're different motherfuckers. You know when you listen to an Eminem song, you know when you listen to a Slim Shady song, you know when you listen to a Marshall Mathers song. You feel what I'm saying? Like, they're completely different, bro. It's like, how can I put this to where y'all can understand it a little bit deeper? You know when you listening to a Young Jeezy song, you know when you listening to a Snowman song. You feel what I'm saying? Just like that. You know when you listen to a Drake song, you know when you're listening to a Drizzy song. You know when you listen to a Drizzy Drake. So, is this Slim Shady taking back over? Is what I'm getting at. And that's what's going on.
Liquid Tylenol, gelatin.
skeletons, think my skeleton's melting. Wicked, I get all high when I think I smell the scent of elephant manure. Hell, I'm in Kahlua, screw it, to hell with it. I went through hell with accelerants and blew up myself again. Volkswagen, tailspin, bucket matches my pale skin. Meowing, went from Hellman's and being rail thin for half it. Scribble Jam, Rap Olympics, 97, Freak Nick, how can I be down mean? Bazaar in Florida, Bruce Room, slept on the Florida motel then. Dr. Dre said, hell yeah, and I got it stamped like a postcard, word to mailman. And I know they're gonna hate, but I don't care. I barely can wait to hit him with the snare and the bass square in the face. This fucking world better prepare to get laced, because they're gonna taste my venom. I got that venom.
So pretty much it's an effect. It's an effect, like the Maya's touch. Wherever he touched, turned to gold. Whatever he touched becomes shady. Is that what's going on? That's what I gather. Personal opinion. The whole motherfucking family just got it. My nigga went from that son to the mama to the daddy. The mama tried to stop the son. The son tried to stop me. Mama tried to stop the son and daddy tried to stop the mama. And this motherfucker jumped out the goddamn window. Ain't that a motherfucking coinky dink? Metaphorically. Son come home tripping, mama can't control him, daddy try to take over, mama get on some bullshit, daddy out this motherfucker, fuck that bitch.
Gonna catch a hot one, it's evident I'm not done. Fit venom is the thought spun like a weapon, you're discarding them. Held against your will like a hubcap or a mud flap, beat strangler attack. So this ain't gonna feel like a love tap. Eat painkiller pills, fuck a blood track like what's her name's at the wheel. Then a cup Patrick through the car in the reverse at the Indian nut crash in India. The back of the just mangled steel, my Mustang in the Jeep Wrangler, the grill with the front smashed, much as my rear fender assassin. Slim be a combination of an actual kamikaze and Gandhi. Translation, I will probably kill us both when I end up back in India. You ain't gonna be able to tell what the fuck's happened in India when you're bit with the
venom. Turn the venom, venom, not going with 'em. Never gonna slow up in 'em. Ready to snap any momentum. Thinking it's time to go get 'em. They ain't gonna know what hit 'em
when they get bit with the
venom. I got that.
Turn the venom, 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 not.
This videography and the edits and the transitions, bruh, is fucking bananas, my nigga. See, I don't just pay attention to the lyrics. I don't just pay attention to the beat. I don't just pay attention to the artist and the song. I don't just pay attention to what's going on in the video. I'm paying attention to all this shit. You smell what I'm saying? Like, cause I feel my job as a reactor. Just to give y'all my reaction and shit. And if I see some shit and I really like these transitions, I pay attention to transitions, which is why if you're on my Instagram, to all you artists, I gave some advice to y'all. If y'all not on my Instagram, definitely go add my Instagram. What's the deal? _LB1200. For real.
I said knock knock, let the devil in, alien, Elliot phone home. Ain't no telling when this chokehold on this game will end. I'm loco, became a symbiote, so my fangs are in your throat, ho. You're snake bitten with my with the ballpoint pen, I'm gun cock, bump stock, double lock, buckshot, tie top of Uggarot, tie couple knots, fired up and caught fire, juggernaut, punk rock, bitches going down like Young Jock, cause the doc put me on like Sun Rock. Why the fuck not, you only get one shot, ain't shit.
I didn't see that coming, my nigga. Oh, I didn't see that coming. I did not see the Chihuahua coming, my nigga. For real, for real. Goddamn. Oh, wow. I will say, this is one of his best bodies of work, bro. Guys.
Till I can't taste it, chased it with stray liquor, then bathed in it, then drank till I faint and awake with a headache, and I take anything in rectangular shape, then I wait. To face the demons I'm bonded to, cause they're chasing me, but I'm part of you, so escaping me is impossible. I latch onto you like a
parasite, and I probably ruined your parents' life and your childhood too. Cause if I'm the music that y'all grew up on, I'm responsible.
Fucking genius. Like I said, a fucking genius. Parents, remember when we was kids? And he was just looked upon as like the worst of the worst. Fucking like ironic that it's a white nigga that was looked upon in the rap industry as the worst of the worst. The parents, like, go fucking figure, right? But remember when MTV pulled his shit? When his shit wasn't getting played on BET and all, and this nigga was going at everybody in the motherfucking industry, bruh. And he would even put in his songs, like, what was that song? So Don't Blame Me, when little Eric Jones was off the terrace. You should have been watching him. My parents, you ain't parents. I never knew. I knew I would get this big. I never knew. I knew that affect this kid. I never knew. I get him to slit his wrist. I never knew. I get him to hit this bitch. But the whole time, he used to like just say he's not a role model. Don't look up. Don't. I'm not who your kids are supposed to be looking up to. Like, what the fuck are y'all making it seem like I'm this, like I'm A, B, and C, my nigga, when really needs to worry about what's going on behind your motherfucking doors. But if your kids was raised off my music and you looking at me like this, then hey, I'm the parasite that clicked onto this whole shit. And imagine if it was like in white America, I never would have dreamed in a million years I see a million motherfucking people who feel like me, who share the same views and the same exact beliefs. It's like a fucking army marching in back of me. You feel what I'm saying? But also, you could flip that to the cleaning out my closet. Have you ever been hated on or demonstrated? Have you ever been hated on or discriminated against? I have. I've been protested and demonstrated against. Picking signs for my wicked rhymes. Look at the times. Sick as the mind of the motherfucking kid that's behind all this emotionless. Like, bro, he's been telling you for a while. And just imagine to the kids that grew up on that with the same mindset that he have. Bottom line, the motherfucking world in trouble, bruh. At least that's what I gather.
For you, the Garston fools, I'm the super villain. Dad and mama's losing their marbles too. You marvel that Eddie Brock is you, and I'm the suit. So call me Venom. I got that adrenaline momentum. Not knowing when I'm ever gonna slow up in 'em. Ready to snap any momentum. Thinking it's time to go get 'em. They ain't gonna know what hit 'em. When they get beat with the venom. I got that adrenaline momentum. Not knowing when I'm ever gonna slow up in 'em. Ready to snap any momentum. Thinking it's time to go get 'em. They ain't gonna know what hit 'em. When they get beat with the.
Yeah, gas station of M on that, bruh. That motherfucker was. Look, I know I said a lot, so I want to give y'all time to. Yeah. Please, please get in the comment box and let me know, bro, what y'all take was. Like, if I ain't never meant that shit before, I mean that shit now. Get in this motherfucker and let me know what y'all take is on this motherfucker, for real, for real. Tell a friend, subscribe to the motherfucking YouTube channel. And if you rocking with my motherfucking Eminem, subscribe to the YouTube channel, bruh. LB, for what's the deal? And I'm gone. 200. Damn.
Do it live for the dead homies. Fuck you and your dead homies. I put dead homies on your head, homie. Appeal money for the